Hi, Lonnie Mackley here. I just want to talk to you a little bit today about demons and addiction and how demonic entities can get a hold of somebody's life that is practicing an addiction. If you're practicing an addiction, this is something that might be very important for you to learn about, because whether you believe it or not, or whether you know it or not, there is a spiritual realm that's invisible that mixes in with human life. You can't see them, and you're probably lucky that you can't, but they're there. And what a demon's job is here, so to speak, is to tempt and test mankind. The demons are the fallen angels. There was a war in heaven, and one third of the angels fought with Satan, and they lost. And so they were cast out of heaven and sent here to the earth. Jesus said himself that he saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven to the earth. And ever since then, Satan and these demons that try to take over heaven, they hate God. They hate everything that God loves, especially his creation, mankind. And if you're mankind, which you are, to be listening to this, he hates you. He's not your friend. He may act like your friend to draw you in to eventually destroy you, but he absolutely hates you. Make no mistake about it. Now, demons have different natures to them. They're kind of like specialists. There's some that may be demons of addiction, or demons of murder, or demons of this, or demons of that. And they come in different ranks. There's a man named Howard O. Pittman that was allowed to see the other side, to see the spirit realm, to see what was there. And he described them that, and the Bible says too, that there are different ranks or echelons of angels. Just like there are in heaven, like there's archangels, there's different ranks down here on the earth too. But their job is to kill, steal, and destroy everything in your life. And the only gateway that they have into your life is through sin. But Howard Pittman was allowed to see beyond this realm. It's like he was allowed to put on spiritual glasses, so to speak, to see everything that's behind there. Actually, he got a tour of it with a couple of angels. But what he saw was just, he was allowed to look down the street, and he saw the regular people watching down the street, and then he saw evil spirits going down the street at the same time as these people. And he was just taken from place to place and kind of given a tour of the spirit realm. And one of the things that he saw was somebody that was sitting and watching a porn movie, and he saw this demon that looked like a frog. Sometimes they look like these weird little creatures. And some of the demons that are the lower echelon of demons, they look like these, you know, crazy little animals. And this was a frog. And as this man began to give himself over more and more to the lust of this movie that he was watching, this frog kept crawling up his chest, and each time that it got to be more and more. And then he had a woman over that he was, you know, getting romantically involved with, and having sex, getting ready to have sex, and the spirit was there again, and it was just crawling up this people's chest, and eventually it went into this person's mouth. And once they get a hold of you, they have a lot more power. It's like a criminal only has so much control or power over you outside of your house, but once they get in your house, then they have a lot more control and power, and it's the same way. And once a demon gets inside of you through your activity of breaking God's laws, that's their legal right to come in. Then they will push you, and you will feel obsessed to gratify their desires. You see, demons, they get gratification from the addiction and the sins that you commit. They get a piece of the pie, so to speak. So they want you to go do these activities, so they're going to push you. And no matter what it is, no matter how they got there, they are there, and the only thing that can get them out is Jesus Christ. So once you get one operating in your life, you don't have to be possessed like Linda Blair in The Exorcist, where you're, you know, barfing up pea soup or having your head spin around. All you have to do is start breaking God's laws, and they have every legal right to come into your life. And the more that you do it, and the more that you allow your heart to be given over to it, the more power and control that they have. And you can get fully possessed. If you do something long enough and you give yourself over to it enough, you can get possessed. But possession, full possession, is actually pretty rare. So that's how demons get into your life. And once they're there, they mix in with your personality. And you may think that you're, you know, there's certain parts of your personality may not even be the real you. They may just be things that are driving you toward those kinds of behaviors because the demons feed off of that. You may think, you may wonder, well, if you're a Christian, can this happen to you? And every Christian, they have a hedge that's built up around them of protection that God gives you. But when you sin, when you continuously break God's laws in a certain area, it creates a hole in that hedge, and an evil spirit is allowed to come in. And it doesn't mean that they can fully possess you. If you have the Holy Spirit living inside of you, they cannot fully take you over, but they can come inside, and they can get a real grip on your life. And I've had to undergo what they call deliverance and of a spirit at a time in my life when there was just, I had just gone through a divorce, and there was just a lot of really bad things going on, and I'd really given myself over to addiction for a while, and so I had to be delivered. And I can tell you firsthand that whatever had a hold of me wasn't my imagination, but Jesus did drive it out, and I've been free ever since. And so I just want to let you know that if you're a Christian too, if you give yourself over to sin, you can have demons operating in your life. And it's almost like a town. The city hall may be, you know, fine, you know, upstanding, good people there, but then you always usually have a street that's controlled by, you know, the lower end of people in your town. And that's how it can be in a Christian's life. Jesus Christ may be living in your heart, the Holy Spirit may be controlling you, but through your sin, you've allowed other things to begin to take over different parts of the town. And Jesus, of course, wants to be in control of the whole town, but that's up to you. By your volition of will, you either drive something out or allow something in. So he wants you to keep it out. Now, how do you get rid of these things once they're there? I mean, is there any way to get rid of them? Well, yes, there is. You ask Jesus Christ to help you. There's different ways to kick these things out of your life. One of them is to starve them out. First of all, you've got to stop the behavior that gives them legal rights to be there. You can squeeze them out by getting enough of God in your life. The demons cannot stand to be around the Holy Spirit or anything that's holy. And so that can drive them out. Or you can actually do a deliverance, which is kind of like an exorcism, but that's where somebody prays for you and drives it out. And how do you know if you're demonized? I mean, how do you know? There are certain signs. For one thing, you feel very driven in a certain area, almost against your will. You may have, like, language and actions that just start on their own, or you may have blackouts. But something else is definitely there that has mixed itself in with you. And the more control it gets, the more it takes over. And a lot of people's blackouts during addiction are actually spirits that have fully taken you over for a period of time. That's why you don't remember any of it. It's not just the drugs or alcohol. So there's a website that you can go to called Spirit Led Recovery from Addiction, Revival Prophetic Wilderness. But there's also one called Christian Help for a Haunting. If you need more help or prayer, you're going to need inner healing along with your deliverance to kind of take away the root structure to the tree of the demon that's been in your life. There's things that happened in your childhood that have allowed certain things to come into your life, wounds, trauma, those kinds of things. Even other people's sins in your family line can bring a demonic activity in your life. So there'll be help on that website. Just type in Lonnie Mackley to the Yahoo browser. You should find it. Or go to my YouTube homepage, and it lists the links to the groups there as well. And look for a deliverance ministry in your town or a deliverance minister. They're hard to find because people don't believe in demons these days that much. They're starting to more now. If you're not sure where to go in your town, just find a Pentecostal church, spirit-filled church, or a prophetic type of church, and ask for help. But pray for God to send you the help that you need if you've got something going on in your life. I would just want to encourage you that you can be free. God will lead the right person to you, and you don't have to put up with it. But you will, just like with Mary Magdalene, that Jesus has cast out 7 devils. He said to go and to sin no more after he cast them out. And you're going to have to go and sin no more to keep them out. So bless you, my friend. I hope this has helped you a little bit. And just understand that who the Son sets free, Jesus is free indeed. Okay? Bye-bye.